In this video, we are going to discuss about the factor considered for the design of the centrifugal pump. So we will discuss here the five factors which we consider while designing of the centrifugal pump. Okay, so what we will discuss in this video, we will discuss first of all the factor, which factor we are consider. Second, why we consider these factors. Okay, and in our upcoming videos, when we will discuss about the design of the centrifugal pump and the sizing of the centrifugal pump, then we will discuss about the each factor in detail, right? So in this video, we are going to discuss about the what are these five factors. Let's suppose with respect to interview, and if someone asks you about it, so you must know that which are the factors which we consider and what are the reason behind it, right? So let's start the video. Hello engineers, welcome in Core Engineering YouTube channel. If you are new in our YouTube channel, please subscribe our YouTube channel, press the bell icon so that you could get the latest notification, right? So our first factor is that fluid used, means which type of fluid you are going to use in the centrifugal pump, right? On the basis of that, the MOC will be decided. Right, on the basis of that, okay, first of all the fluid, which type of fluid you are using, then what we will discuss there, we will discuss about what you will see here. You will see when we are talking about the fluid, so you will see the viscosity, you will see the density, temperature, specific gravity, then the vapor pressure at any particular temperature, because these factors are very, very important. Okay, we are not going in detail in each of the factor, but you must know if I am saying the fluid, okay, the type, which type of fluid we are handling. So it means that why we are considering, or why we are saying that, because the fluid can be like there may be any fluid which has a high viscosity, and there may be another fluid which has less viscosity. Then there may be a fluid which has the solid content is more. Okay, and there may be some fluid which will not have a solid particles, which will not have a foreign particles. It means that which type of strainer you have to use and the mass size of the strainer, that you will decide, right? So that's why the fluid used is very, very important. Got it my points, what I want to say? Because like, let's suppose sometimes there will be the water, sometimes there will be the like molten urea, sometimes there will be the carbamate, sometimes there may be any other solution that may be viscous, that may be less density, less, right? So on the basis of that, your pump will be designed. Got it my points? Means pump internals will be designed. Okay, and the second most important factor which we consider, that is the flow required. Okay, that flow required we also consider, or we also represent it as a Q. The flow required, you can say, or you can simply say capacity. Okay, that is very, very important. Means you must know that what is the capacity of your centrifugal pump. That is mainly expressed in the cubic meter per hour, right? So capacity is mainly expressed in the terms of volumetric flow rate, that is the Q. Means how much amount of fluid or how much volume that your centrifugal pump is lifting per unit time, or you can say the per hour. Got it my points? The flow rate is also very, very important. And the second thing is that the power consumption in the centrifugal pump is mainly dependent on the Q. Mainly dependent on the Q. If your flow rate will be increased, so your power consumption will be also increased. Because why? Because it is a constant head pump. Because it is a constant head pump, right? I hope you understood about it. Here I am, when I am saying this, so I am saying with respect to operation point of view, right? Why I am saying this? I am saying this with respect to the operation when it has been installed. So the flow required and the capacity is also very, very important. Okay, now the next important factor is total head. Head is also very, very important. When you will see the pump curve, if you have studied about the pump curve, so you will see that the pump curve is expressed head versus Q. It is expressed as head versus Q. Okay, can you let me in the comments box why it is expressed at head versus Q? Why not P versus Q? Okay, please let me in the comments box if you know, right? If I talk about the normally head, so what is the head mainly? So what is the unit of the head? The unit of the head is the meter, right? It means that what is the head? Head is the height of the fluid column equivalent to the total pressure difference, right? You can see the total pressure differential, okay, which is mainly measured before and after the device, okay? That is very, very important. This head is very, very important because you must know that how far your centrifugal pump will lift the fluid. Okay, that's why it is in meter. Right, that we will also discuss in our upcoming videos. In detail, we will discuss about it. We will also express the formulas. We will derive the equations as well. That is also very, very important. Right, and the fourth factor which we consider, that is the NPSHA and NPSHR. What is it means? It means that net positive suction head available and net positive suction head required. Okay, what is the difference between that? This NPSHR, that is the required, which is given by the vendor. This NPSHA, that is the net positive suction head available. Now, for the safer operation, your NPSHA should be always greater than the NPSHR, right? What is the difference between NPSHA and NPSHR? This NPSHR is calculated, the vendor calculates it, okay? I'll tell you in my upcoming videos how it is calculated, okay? And what is the significance of it? What is the shutoff head that we all consider in later? And this is the NPSHA available. So this is, okay, why NPSH is required? What is NPSH mainly? NPSH is nothing but the suction pressure, the difference between the suction pressure, okay, means the suction side pressure minus the vapor pressure of that fluid. Okay, that is the NPSH. Right, so that's why it should be always positive. If it will be negative, it means that the cavitation can be there. Okay, if the cavitation will be there, so that is the different thing. And about the cavitation, I have already made 4-5 videos. You can check it out in the centrifugal pump playlist. Why NPSH is required? For smooth operation. Okay, for the pump flexibility, for the pump safety, NPSH is must. That's why you can simply say here, the suction side pressure minus vapor pressure, okay, that difference is a net positive suction head, and that's why it should be always positive. And that's why I say the NPSHA is always greater than the NPSHR required, right? And in the last, efficiency, right? Efficiency is also very, very important. Why it is important? Because let's suppose if you have to send your liquid from here to here, and when you did the simulation, when we were doing the design, then we found that the efficiency, what the efficiency which we are getting, that is 60%, but that is not good for us, okay, in with respect to the cost, that is not good for us. So what we did, can we use the double stage centrifugal pump? Can we use the multi-stage centrifugal pump? Okay, what we could do for increase the efficiency, or we will have to compromise with this efficiency. Okay, if our requirement is matching and with respect to cost, so this efficiency must be considered. Okay, because if the efficiency will be high, okay, it will, first of all, it will be best for your cost. Initial cost, I'm not talking about the initial cost, I'm talking about the operational cost. Okay, so the efficiency is also considered, means what the client wants, means how much efficiency the client wants, and if he wants, he or she wants that efficiency, so what we will have to do, whether we will have to change the design of the impellers or the size of the impellers, or we will have to do something else, okay, whether we will have to like increase the RPM, that we must discuss or that we must consider in the pump efficiency, right? So that all the things we consider while designing the centrifugal pump, and these are the main 5 factors which we mainly consider in the designing or in the centrifugal pump sizing. And if you know more factors which you think that, sir, you haven't discussed that factor, please let me in the comments box. okay, in our upcoming videos, we are going to discuss about it in depth, right? So thanks for the today's video. If you learned something new in this video, so simply like this video, share this video with your friends. So thanks for watching. Till then, keep learning.